Okay, so starting off with a clean face, just gonna address the elephant in the room, this huge old spot living on the side of my face.
I'm starting off with this foundation by Benefit. This is a new one. It's called their, I think it's like their Happy Something. It's Happy Something in the name. I'm in the shade number 5 and I decided to try this out because I'd seen so many people use it and rave about it because it's meant to like really blur out your skin and that's definitely needed today. I said this was my first time using it. I do really, really like it. Did get sent this foundation a couple weeks ago, so it is way too light for me. Since then I have got a tan. If I did get a darker color, I think I would really like this foundation. I also just hydrated my lips with some Nivea Cherry Shine, such an OG. Then I went in with concealer. This is my favorite drugstore concealer ever, and it's also the most full coverage concealer I own. Out of all my high-end ones, all my like cheaper ones, this one is the best, and this is the EX1 Delete Concealer. I'm in the shade 3, so it's very brightening under my eyes. And I knew that the spot I had next to my nose wouldn't fully cover just because it was very textured, but I tried my best, and I think this concealer did pretty well, and it was also super painful as well. Like, it genuinely made my eyes water trying to cover this up. I don't know why it's so painful. It's so annoying. But then I just blended that out with a denser brush just to make sure it was all blended in. So for bronzer, I used something that was my favorite last year. I don't know why, but I always go back to this during summer. And this is actually a foundation stick. I'm pretty sure it is a foundation stick. It's by MAC and I'm in the shade 7.5. I just bought the darkest one you could get. Absolutely love this as cream bronzer. Little tip, if you're like me and your undertone is a little bit hard to match sometimes foundation wise, it's usually the same with bronzer. I just buy a really dark foundation, whether it's powder foundation or like a stick like I'm using today. And then it suits your skin tone so much more. So I really, really recommend that if you are finding it hard to find a bronzer with the right undertone for your skin. I was literally blending this with my eyes closed. I don't know why you guys follow me at this point, but thank you. So for my eyebrows, I of course had to use my favorite. You guys already know I'm obsessed with this product. Can you tell? Maybe just a tiny bit. This is the Pony FX Defining Brow Pencil. I absolutely love this. This is so good. I literally just carry this in my bag everywhere with me. Little fun fact, I actually did my brows myself this time. I had an appointment with Benefit. I get my brows done at like the Benefit Brow Bar. There's been so many protests for Trump in London at the moment, and they're like right next to where I get my eyebrows done. So I couldn't make my appointment because it was just so packed. So I had to do my eyebrows at home, and I'm actually really happy with the shape of them. I think I did a pretty good job. I don't know, I usually mess them up so much, so I just like pluck them at home and I think the shape is pretty good. So I just filled in any sparse areas and then it was just checking them, making sure there was no harsh lines. I realized I had a double chin and literally like shivered. So for my eyes, I decided to use the Kylie Bronze Palette because I haven't used it in so long and I really, really like the colors in it. So I started off with the lightest shade. I'm pretty sure it's called Jasper. It's just like a off-white kind of shade. And then I went in with Tiger Eye, which is a warmer brown, in my crease with a fluffy brush. And then with a smaller brush, I went in with, I think it was Bronzite I used, which is like a more warmer, slightly more orange tone brown. Then for like a little bit of shimmer, I decided to use this one by NARS. Unfortunately, it doesn't have individual names, but I'll link it down below. The Kylie palette does actually have some shimmers in it, but I personally think they're a little bit too cool tone for the look I was going for because I wanted more of like a golden look. So when the sun hits you during golden hour, I just wanted to have that shimmer right in the like inner corner of my eyes. It does have a shimmer if you are looking at this palette and you want it. It does have that shimmer option available to you. And then lastly, because I suck at doing liquid liner, I decided to just use some black shadow and just wing out my eyes slightly. I do prefer gel liner. I just used some shadow for today. Then I just curled my lashes. It's essential for me because I have the straightest lashes on earth. And then I use a new cult favorite, actually. I discovered this only a couple weeks ago, but I really, really like it. And this is the Clinique 24-Hour Waterproof Mascara. See, it's so waterproof. I used this in the pool the other day. My mascara did not budge at all, so I really recommend this for summer. It is a really good mascara. powder, I of course had to use a fave, especially during this hot weather, and this is the Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder. I decided to bake under my eyes. I feel like baking always makes your makeup look so flawless. Even though this is a more high-end product, it lasts forever, so I do really recommend it. Then I also decided to bake my jawline because I don't even know why. I saw Kylie do this in a Vogue video and I basically just copied her. I wanted to know what it did because I've never done it before. Then I just use a little bit of blush. This is Orgasm by NARS. It has a really weird name, but it's honestly such a nice blush. Then I just line my lips with a nude liner by Primark. Unfortunately, it doesn't have a name. It was like literally £1 and it's the best lip liner ever. I use this every single day. I just like blend it out so there's no harsh lines. And then for like my actual lip color, I didn't know if I wanted to use a gloss or a more matte color, but seeing as it was like a golden hour kind of vibe, I decided to go for a gloss. This one is by Chanel. You of course don't need to use a Chanel lip gloss. This was actually a present from India, so thank you India, love you girl. This is in the shade Melted Honey. It's a really really nice lip gloss. I wiped away any excess powder and then moved on to highlight. So when it comes to golden hour and selfies and just generally like golden toned makeup, I immediately think of this highlight by Iconic. It's amazing. It's literally just liquid gold. It looks so good. But that is the finished makeup look. This is my perfect golden hour look. I really hope you guys enjoyed this. If you take any selfies with this makeup, definitely tag me so I can see them. Also follow me on Snapchat or Instagram if you don't already. I always link them down below. But thank you guys so much for watching and I'll see you soon.